What's going on, YouTube?
It's your boy, Real You, Good Duels, coming at you on an episode today. I said I would never open another one of these. I said the last was going to be my last one. The one before that was going to be my last one. And here I am with another mystery pile box. But I have a little bit of a difference than the other ones. I did a little bit of research online, and there's a way to tell to get the PSA graded cards in these. And some of the obvious ways is literally just the indentations. I mean, I'm going to probably grab the box, felt around for it. But really didn't realize that the Shonen Jump, the Beckett cards, these cards, are they Beckett? I forgot they call them anyway. There's different brands. But anyway, if you squeeze them, you can feel for the cards. And like this one, you can actually see in some of the outline. Let me see if I can do it for you guys. Get it for you guys right here. Hold on one second. Let me see if you guys can see it. Where's the focus map? There you go. You can actually see the outlines at an angle. It's going up. The star decks, in these boxes, half of them is a crappy playmat. The other half is packs, the star deck, which is back here, and in the front right here is a PSA grade card. So once again, guys, let me see if you guys can see that. Especially over here. And it is hard as hell. Normally when you squeeze these, especially in the sides, sometimes the PSA grade card's right here, by the way, guys. And sometimes you could take your thumb, push it in, and push it like this. But you gotta be careful, though, because you don't want to be hitting the star deck and thinking, oh, that's a PSA grade card. No, these cards are heavy and hard as hell. Once again, let me see if you guys see it with my finger. And the outline is perfectly here. Once again. Here's, I can feel the end right here, I can feel the end right here, and it could go up the whole thing. Guaranteed PSA in these, guys. They're never in the back, do not ever check the back. Like I said, it's going to be the playmat's going to be on this side. Over here, it's going to be the playmat. The star deck box is going to be over here. A couple of packs over here, and that little lip thing with a bunch of those crappy-ass battle packs over there. A majority of the time, the PSA grade cards normally going to be over here, guys, like this. Or you get lucky sometimes, like I just did, and it's at an angle, which is at right here. I've never seen over here. I watch every single PSA video, by the way, on YouTube, because I just wanted to know, because I wanted to know, a mystery power box, I should really say, because I wanted to know where the PSA grade cards were, so I could do this kind of video for you guys, so you guys can now go out to your Walmart, wherever, and fill it out. It's really hard not to find it at this point now. I think now it's just easy. I can just squeeze really hard and... Like I said, I could figure this out. This is 100% a PSA grade card in this box. Guaranteed, guys. And like I said, it's like if they're standing up, you can still put your finger here, like this, and push in. See how I push in? And then you get this. See? Look at that. Clean box. But if the PSA grade, see if I can get to its side. Can't really do it that good, but... Yeah, wait a second. Can't really shake it to the side that well, but here's a corner of it. Like I said, you can feel the difference. I can feel the star deck right here, and there's a big lump right here, and right there. Like I said, some of you guys might be thinking I'm crazy, some of you guys might be thinking I'm not gonna do that one. But if you want a PSA grade card, instead of paying $500 for buying crap, because most of these are garbage. In fact, 99% of these are other trash. Even a PSA grade card, sometimes you don't even plus in then, but you know, plus then, as long as you actually lose value. Alright, plastic. Let's do this. Fuck you this time, plastic. I brought keys. So enough of me talking. Let me start opening this and show you guys. Because there's no PSA grade card. Lols. And I'm uploading this video either way, by the way. If I don't open it, I'm uploading this video. Just to tell you how much I hate this damn PSA. But nah, it's definitely in there. So, crack the box. And you guys can see. Hopefully you guys can see it right there. Go behind like this, makes it a little bit easier. It's right through the PSA. Like I said, here's the playmat. There's a star deck box and the PSA grade cards outside of it. Here's the packs. You can see if we get a better look into it. Sometimes it's never like that, sometimes it's a little to the corner. So once it gets still in there, and then that's when we get like skeptical. It's still in there into that. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take it. We'll put it face down. Put a face down. I don't know what it is. Let's open this box. All right, First, we'll open the thing I hate the most. Actually, we'll see, we'll check the playmat out. Let's see. I think there's only really two playmats. It's this one and there's the other battle pack playmat. Jesus, Konami dropped the ball big time with this. Dragoon's Legion Star deck box. Can you guys just get a... There you go. Let's see. Guys, comment below. Let me know what you guys think about these Monster Pack Battle Leagues. Did you guys get anything good in yours? If you ever got any of these? Raging Mad Pet. Maging Mad Plants. Leotard. Oh, Rare Card Trooper. Common Valhalla. And Submarinoid. I am in no mood today, Plastic. Alright. Unstable Evolution. Foil Unstable Evolution. Flame Tire. Dark Rive. Oh, I guess Dark Rive's pretty decent. Yeah, so I'm sure you guys can see it really good. Alrighty. Bloodfly Yoki, Fusion Sword, Mashimer Blade, Arsenal Bug, Psychokinesis, Chain Dog. Yeah, that's probably not the way to say the card's name, but I'm too tired at this point. Raging Mad Plant, Machine King Prototype, Ancient Gear Knight, Intrigue Shield, Destructor Tron. By the way, happy 4th of July. That noise in the background, that's fireworks going off, so I'm about to eat dinner and the lights from fireworks in a few myself, but Book of Eclipse, Noble Knights at Future there are. Skelosaurus, another shitty card, followed by its other friend shitty card. Here is the I'm not gonna open it. I'll probably do it later on. I mean, does it really matter, guys? One second. I'm trying to zoom in for you guys. There you go. It's Dragoon Knight bullshit. Miss Valley Falcon, which everyone thinks is Miss Valley Glenna Bird. I get that a lot, by the way. Dragon's Ravine. United Stand, Mage Power. Fool's Burial. What's on with Taqua? I definitely butchered that name. Legacy Alagarasu, Mirror Force. Yeah, this is, you know. Yeah. Okay. Let's crack these packs open. Whatever, I'll play my iPad. I just got a tripod for my iPad. Is that okay? So my shoulder zooms, alright. I just got in a tripod for my iPad and I'm kind of like it. So it only came with three packs? Okay, I thought it was. No, it did. Okay. So we'll open Judgment of Light first. So you're pulling this sweet super. By the way, I hear these are Euro packs, which is kind of funny because Konami doesn't normally let us play Euro cards. Googly Eyes Stone Dragon. Confronting the Sea, the one nobody plays. Star Leech Lord Galaxion, which has a really cool artwork. I don't know why Konami's letting us have these for Euro packs, but you know, we're having problems with Euro cards. Guys, comment below, let me know what you guys think about that. Ghost Ship Jack Force. Leo! This pack's already a winner. Was that the only. Oh, yeah, okay. So, got a Leo. Last pack, Primal Origins. Yeah, the Tomahawk, which would have been worth something had it didn't get reprinted, but still, it's pretty cool. I think it would have been worth something because of link format. And, yeah, no. Ass. Alright, guys. The moment we've been waiting for. Is this, can I get some zoom on this bitch? There we go. So it is back. Okay, I was right. Invader of Darkness. Not even the set one, the limited edition one. Is everyone getting this fucking card? I mean, it's a 10 grade Invader of Darkness, of the limited edition one. But is anyone else getting this card as well? Or is it just me? I feel like I'm the only one getting this card. So, let me just go over this real quickly for you guys. This was like this in the box. There we go. This was like this in the box. Sometimes it could be like this in the box. Especially with, I already put the playmat away, but especially with the playmat, it would be like this. Behind it is the deck. So the star deck box is this, and this is this, okay? Sometimes if it's straight like this, which is rare in the box, if it's like this, and you push it aside, you're going to hit this. But, see that? What you want to do is, when it's in the box, and I'll put it in the box to show you guys. See it like that? Take your thumb like this, you hold it down, or you hold it down like this, and go with your finger, and you can feel it. Push hard. And that's how you can tell. Now, it was just the starter deck box in there. Same scenario. You hold it down. You push hard. You can actually feel like it feels like a double kind of crimp. Okay, I'll do it again. We'll do it from the inside view so you guys can see. Fuck. Give me 1 second. See, now it's starting to open, but it doesn't feel too sturdy. But with this on top of it, it feels a hell of a lot sturdier. And this is what I've been doing, by the way, on my free time. And not only that, like I said, one of the obvious things you could do is literally feel around. And you can feel it on top. And you can feel that, you can see the outline right here perfectly. You can see the outline perfectly, right? The Star Deck box, oh fuck, now it's starting to come apart. The Star Deck box won't give you that big of an outline. It will start folding up. It might feel solid in the middle, but the middle doesn't mean shit. It gotta be solid in the corners. If you don't feel solid corners, it's not happening. It might also feel solid too when you're hitting this in here. When you're hitting that, it feels solid, but even still, it's always outside in front of the deck box. It's never behind the deck box, from what I noticed. It's always been in front of the deck box. On the right side, of course, those sides of the play mats, and it's always around here, if not in the middle. It's really rarely up here with the packs. In fact, if it is with the packs, you can always do this, shake it down, and it'll drop down to the deck box. Hopefully that helps you out, guys. I might get some more, whenever I can find some more, guys. And you can try it again, and hopefully get something better than a fucking Invader of Darkness or some other PSA great card I had. But yeah, it's this. But at least now I personally know how to look for graded cards in these boxes. So every time I'm gonna do a video of myself opening one of these boxes, it's gonna be a graded card guaranteed in it. The only question is what graded card. I know everyone hates me doing these videos. I get a lot of hate for doing these videos. I get a lot of flack for doing these fucking videos. And I understand it, but I found it really into the trick now. So every time I pay $25, besides these horrible cards you get, and the start that's, you know, this that nobody cares about, and the playmat that only midgets could use, actually, I now get PSA graded cards. So I'll probably be buying these just for the PSA graded cards, which kind of sound dumb, but I really like opening these and pulling these. You know, try it out at your local Walmart, guys. Walmart's not gonna, I highly doubt nobody at Walmart's gonna bother you guys while you look for while you're feeling through. As long as you buy them, as long as they're still sealed, Walmart can't do shit to you. I'm not sure about Target. I'm pretty sure Target does the same thing. You got money. As long as you got money, they should learn to fucking do your shit. Anyway, guys, I'm been rambling too long. I'm about to go eat dinner. I do appreciate you guys watching this video, and I know I'm gonna get I know I'm gonna get like 20,000 thumbs down because people will be like, this PSA graded card is shit. And yeah, you're right. It is shit. But at least now I know how to fucking find the PSA graded cards. I spent, I don't even know how many of these boxes I bought and recorded on camera. This does not count the ones I bought off camera, which is another 4. I probably easily dropped $300 in these goddamn boxes. They're addicting. And I hate them. I hate them when they're addicting. It's like a crack, and it's been on crack for 30 years. At that point, you're just doing it because you're doing it. But at least you get PSA graded cards and stuff. Anyway, guys, I appreciate you watching my videos. Your boy, really, you can do this. Subscribe to my shit. That's my 2 cents.